I'm neither an engineer nor an expert in the steel industry. I'm, so to say, in the government parlance, a generalist versus a specialist. Nevertheless, since I was requested to attend this, I felt that I would be interacting with all of you, so I've come here. I didn't expect to be the chief guest. But I would delve more on what the state government has been doing, especially after the formation of Telangana. I also compliment the organizers for making such a big gathering here of experts from the steel industry. And I'm sure the government of Telangana will be at the forefront of encouraging such kind of gatherings. I also take this opportunity to pay my tributes to the Pulwama martyrs before I begin my, I will not say it is a presentation, but an overview of what's happening in Telangana. About the steel industry, you're all experts, so I need not delve on the detail, but as you know, the production of steel in the world is about 1700 million tons per year, and India is the second largest producer of steel in the world, after China, of course, by leaps and bounds they are ahead of us, but we are fast trying to catch up. And the per capita, in terms of per capita consumption of the finished steel also, we are much less, I think around 70 kgs or so, as against the global standard of 250 kgs, and China it is more than 600 to 700 kgs. This data also, recently I was in Beijing for a program, so I came to know about these things, and I was, you might be aware of the same. But the potential for the earlier speakers, Mr. Srikanth, of course, is an expert in this. So he was talking more about the details of the Government of India policy, the lacuna, so to say, in the policy. We don't have a separate policy for the state government, which is, I think, imminent. I think that I'm sure the state government is thinking of it. I, representing the Industrial Infrastructure Corporation, we are definitely a part of the state government, but we are not the policy makers, we are the implementers. So we would be definitely be at the forefront of whatever the policy decision taken by the government, and we are in our own way already encouraging the steel industry in the sense that we have taken up the projects after the formation of Telangana. You might be aware, the Telangana State Industrial Infrastructure Corporation, which is made as the nodal agency for the infrastructure projects in the industry, has been bestowed by our Honorable Chief Minister with a land bank of over 1.5 lakh acres. This itself is one of its kind in the country. No other state has such a large land bank identified. I'll not say we are in possession of the land, but we have identified large areas of land, and in fact we have started in right earnest to acquire through a process of negotiation. You might be aware of the Pharma City, which is coming up near Mucharla on the Srisailam Road. The plans are for acquisition of 20,000 acres. We have already in hand about 8,000 acres of land. Once this is done, this will be one of the largest pharma city or the pharmaceutical products producing area in the world. I also look after a project called the National National Investment Manufacturing Zone, NIMZ. This NIMZ is part of the National Manufacturing Policy of Government of India 2013, wherein it is conceived that manufacturing should be given a major boost, and thereby this NIMZ were contemplated. And we have two NIMZs in Telangana. One is in Hyderabad on the Bombay Highway, about 100 kilometers from Hyderabad, where we have a land bank of already 3,000 acres. The requirement for an NIMZ is that we should have about 12,500 acres plus to be called an NIMZ. So we are in the process of acquiring the balance land. Similarly, the Hyderabad Pharma City also is declared in principle as an NIMZ. The advantage of NIMZ is that we will get a huge quantum of, supposed to get a huge quantum of funding for external infrastructure, and to an extent the internal infrastructure for developing these parks, which is to the tune of about 6,000 crores plus in each case. So with that kind of investment, with that kind of project cost, I'm sure the potential is immense for all the players, whether it is the construction or with buildings or whatever. And I infer indirectly that with these kinds of developments, with the kind of investment that the government is likely to pump in the next few years, which is already being done. You might be aware that we are having such other bigger parks. We have the textile park, which is coming at Warangal, which is already ongoing on an area of 1,200 acres. And this is going to also bring in investments of more than 10,000 crores. We already have one major investor from Korea called Young One, who are going to invest about $150 million. That itself is a huge investment to start with. And we have constructed, we have started the construction work, large part of constructions, the external infrastructure already done, the internal infrastructure in terms of the standard sheds and all these things are going on. We have a medical devices park close to the city near Patancheru called, at a place called Sultanpur. This is again on an area of about 250-300 acres. We have a general park adjoining that, another 250 acres. And we have a FICCI Federation of FICCI FLO, the Women's Federation of FICCI, who have been given about 60 acres of land to set up their own women entrepreneur industries. And so on and so forth. We have larger plans also in the pipeline. So the bottom line is that with this kind of scope that the Telangana government is contemplating, I'm sure the scope for construction, the scope for utilization of steel is immense. As I said, I want to reiterate that I'm not a specialist, so I would not know in what sense, what form, what policy would encourage the utilization of steel in these things. But given the kind of innovation that is happening, our friend Mr. Prasad was talking about the various types of measures that have to be taken, innovations that have to happen in the utilization of steel. I'm sure they will all be put to use by all of you. In the course of the deliberations that would be happening, I'm sure you would be coming up with some kind of guidelines. And I would request you to definitely, at the organization level, meet up with the key persons, both here and at the Government of India level, and try to see how you can harness the scope of government projects into utilization of steel or the growth of the steel industry. So this is the most that I would mention about steel and steel industry vis-a-vis the government. So I once again thank the organizers for inviting me and also compliment them for organizing such an excellent symposium, such an excellent workshop here. And I'm sure this is the starting of your deliberations. I see on the board leading up to the Steel Day in Mumbai and other things. This stepping stone would go a long way in encouraging the steel industry in the country in general and the state of Telangana in particular. And thank you very much again.